It's 5 a.m. Gran died in the night. Mum got the call a few hours ago. She's still crying. I just feel... numb. I tried to go back to sleep. But as soon as I close my eyes, the thoughts keep circling back. We should have been there. We drove to the hospital first thing in the morning. No one said much. It seemed to take forever. I've never seen a dead body before. It might be scary. But it's just Gran. Right? Maybe I should have stayed at home. When we finally arrived, I wasn't so sure about being there at all. We went up the stairs to room 305. Gran's room. Mum gently put her hand on my back and asked me if I wanted to wait outside. I said yes. Hello again, journal. I'm sitting in the waiting room. Just rows of plastic benches in a sea of blue linoleum. And it smells like Ben's bottom cream. A little doodling should distract me from this dreary place. Dad's calling me. Dad had his arm around Mum as they came out of Gran's room. I've never seen her like this. Mums aren't supposed to cry. They're strong. They're meant to know what to do. always. I guess losing your own mum makes you feel like a kid again. The drive home was a quiet one again. It's silly, but I keep thinking back to Gran's favourite vase, the one Granddad gave her. I was running in the house, even though Gran had told me not to. I still remember the noise of the vase smashing into little pieces. Gran was there in an instant. I waited for her to shout. She didn't. She just looked sad. And somehow, that was worse. Gran wouldn't let me pick up the pieces. She found every single one. And carried them into the kitchen. Later, I sneaked in with a tube of glue in hand. It was a mess. I got glue everywhere. But Gran smiled when she saw the vase. She put it in the cupboard. Later, I found it again. When I asked her why she'd binned the vase, she smiled again. Gran always says,
we can't hold on to things forever. Let them live in your memories.
She said she preferred to keep the vase like she remembered it. Maybe I hurt Gran's heart. Weakened it. That can happen, can't it? Maybe this is all my fault. I should have listened to her. I shouldn't have run in the house. Now everything is broken. If I'd started my story sooner, Gran could have read it. It might have helped. I would have fixed her heart. Really? I don't even know how to fix my story. It's a mess. I left Robin to sink into cold, dark waters. She's completely alone. She left behind Lump, her only friend. Okay, focus, Izzy. How can I continue the story? How would she feel about this situation? Robin felt... Ambivalent. We're getting somewhere. Now, let's see. The merchants had been true to their offer. Still, the water closing over her felt like death. Cold and terrifying. I can breathe! This feels so... strange. I wish Lump could have been here. There was nothing I could have done. Was there? But there was no time to dwell on her lost friend. Robin had a dragon to find. Which way did it go? This one. All right. Another branching tunnel. The walls were closing in. Here, I guess. Far too narrow for winged beasts. Did I guess wrong? A dead end. I knew it! Wrong tunnel. No. There must be a way. Think, Robin, think! How do I get up there? Ha! Is this the right way? Lump. But there was no Lump there. No annoying little Lump to complain. No charming Lump to ask for advice either. The submerged tunnels flared outwards, a tangled mess of caverns and hollows. twisting and turning. Bending with almost malicious intent. I need to get out of here. Breathe, Robin. Breathe. I've got to find the dragon. Get back the fireflies. You can do this, Robin. No! She found herself amidst a great coral bed, shimmering with color and life. Wow! This is beautiful! No! Focus! I have to find the dragon. No matter what. Beautiful, and now... It grows back, right? I have a dragon to find. I have to focus on that. No matter what. She spoke those words. But deep in her heart, a seed of chilling doubt took root. Color gave way to darkness, endless and all-consuming. It's cold here. Robbed of sight, the pressure of the deep water on her chest, her thoughts had only one way to go, inwards. What am I doing? I let Lump sacrifice herself for me. And for what? I don't even know where the dragon is, or where I am. I'm falling. I'm failing. Eldorapa. The village. Lump. All of them. Huh? What? Doesn't matter. I need to find the dragon, no matter what. A cold determination gripped her. Numbing all other thoughts. Press forward. dragon. No matter what. There was just the way forward. Barred by an indestructible metal door.
No! I need to find the dragon.
Robin could no longer ignore the seed of doubt. The dragon. No matter what. No matter what. The Seekin seemed friendly.
Hey, have you seen the dragon? Wait.
A host of them greeted her with curious chatter, warm and welcoming.
Have you seen the dragon? Please. No?
But Robin had no time for this.
Let me through! I need to find the dragon, no matter what.
The words felt hollow and meaningless. Freezing cold blanketed Robin. There was comfort in its numbing embrace. She wished she could stay.
Did I do this?
She did this.
Is this my fault?
It was her fault.
They're home. I destroyed it.
A Seekin, encased in ice.
Oh no! What have I done? I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. I never wanted this.
Elder Ava think of me? I'm so selfish!
Guilt dogged her every step.
Did you make me do this?
It would not rest. It would not leave her. It would not cease.
Leave me alone!
The creature looked at her, as if it could see into her very soul. Under its stare, her fears crystallized like ice. She knew that she would... be crushed. You'll shatter me until I'm nothing but dust.
I can't let that happen.
Would Robin embrace her guilt or run from it?